a while ago, a chap asked me to review one of these. I think he knew it was going to be awful, but he just wanted to hear me say so. So I bought one. Crap. But let me just plug the output from that into the camera so you can have a miserable experience all to yourself. Crap.
She's loving that mono mix.
She's got two headphones in as well on the mug. What we got?
This tech lord has said...
We call him tech lord. You know who we're on about. He absolutely slammed this. I got this one though.
So. Oh, even better.
But we're gonna mess with it.
Yeah, we don't think they're totally useless.
Yeah, kind of the point is, he says they're useless. I agree, if you're wanting to play back like a ready recorded.
Yeah, if you want to hear music, then...
Don't buy this. Get buy one of these, like a proper one. You know, with a proper door and that. Don't buy these.
Yeah. Have we... Do we know if this is working? Is this the first time opening this box?
I've never even tested. Oh, it's already started.
Techmoan already had a better job at that than you.
Don't want it.
Push to release.
Cut to me having it clipped on my ear. With headphones in.
You gotta look as joyous as that woman did on the cover. Oh man. Oh, imagine.
Wired headphones as well.
Come on. That's the new look, I think.
What's she listening to?
I don't know, but look as happy as her.
Try a bunch of time.
Oh, we've got a bunch of time. Get that in there.
Wait.
Oh, this thing got a battery in. Oh. Cut to us having batteries.
Love that little ribbon. I'm already tangled up.
I can hear stuff as well. It's making a lot of noise.
I'm not hearing any music.
Oh. Well.
Right, I better put a tape in, don't I? Oh, yeah. Yes.
Let's plan.
I'm gonna get a copyright strike. It sounds shit.
Well, as expected. It's not great.
Right. It's not great. Techmoan was right, but we don't want it to sound normal.
Yeah.
That's the point.
Yeah. At least it works.
It definitely works. It was £8. Okay. Suck on that, Argos.
Yeah, you can pick these up at Argos for like, what, like 10, 15?
No, they're like 25 or something.
What,
no,
for that?
£20, I think, which is an absolute rip-off. Don't pay that much. That's stupid. I think eBay, let's have a quick look. I think a tenner is a fair price, isn't it? £20 on eBay? You're pulling my leg, man. I mean, I've done well to get it for £8. It ain't even worth that.
No.
We don't need headphones, do we?
Not.
Wait, what are we actually building? So speed mod it.
I'm trying to give it the business, yeah.
And then we'll
speed
add
mod it.
Some echo to it, some effects to it, which is just a proper lo-fi. What is it? PT 2339 or whatever it is.
Where are you even reading that?
It's on it. You buy them ready-made for like a few quid.
So we'll get the array's head out of there, turn it into
a little looper.
A little looper, whack a fucking echo boy on there. Somewhere. Pops.
Hang on. It's basically gonna be that.
I don't think people know what this is.
That.
Oh, it's just one of them in there.
With the controls.
Yeah.
And this.
Yeah.
Like this.
Right.
Something like that?
Yeah.
Obviously, that's not the same player. We'll use that little project box. And it'll have to go this side. This bit will be gone, I think. So we take that off. Once we've mounted all our pots and stuff on there that controls this part.
Yeah.
And the tape speed. And we mount this to there.
Yeah.
And that'll be it.
Well, something interesting out of something crappy and cheap.
I think that's it.
Yeah.
Let's get some bits. This is everything we're going to need is... That one will control the playback speed of the tape. No, let's go this way. So that one controls the speed of the echo. So your space in between your echoes. That's like an overdrive for the echo mount. And that is your wet dry mix.
Mm.
And that all attaches to that. This one will attach to this motor that speed that controls the speed of the tape playback.
Right.
But they'll all be mounted in one box. In whatever arrangement you fancy.
Sweet.
And that. And a square battery. That's it.
The box, the pots, the battery, the power, the fucking thing, the inputs and outputs.
What's the switch for? I can't remember. Don't need the switch.
That's all we need.
Okay. That's it. I think.
Should work.
It should work.
By the end of this, if you follow this, you should have something that might work.
Let's bust it open. No, that's the radio. Switch. That's to a speaker that we don't need. Do we need the FM AM switch? Let's just keep it intact, shall we? Why am I using these? We've got a new set.
We're going up in the world.
Proper slow, like
it makes so much noise.
It's just that that makes all the noise. That's why onboard mics for these sort of devices is a joke, really. Because as soon as you hit record, same with people ask us for these, but the reality is, all this rattles. And when you press record, all you can hear is the internals of everything. And it's just not, you know, don't want to be selling that shit. Let's get this baby open. Nice. Quite a nice one to work on because you can have the batteries in.
Oh yeah.
Whilst it's open. But yeah, that tiny little motor there is what controls the tape playback speed. So what's first? I need a bit of cable. And just strip off how much you need. Somewhere around here. And it's gonna be going out here to a It's going to be that way coming into this box. Mm-hmm. Don't need two loads of cable, does it? That's the cable to the speaker. I'm going to be jacking that speaker. That's your output from the main thing to what would have been the speaker. We're going to take that output and run it to the input of this.
So any sound that's being played through here gets fed through this echo circuit, and then it will come back out.
And we are lo-fi gods.
It's that easy.
What else was it? Speaker. Tape speed. Mic. Needs to be our line in. Who did this?
Bits on the board that you actually need to jump onto are usually labelled. Handy.
For once. So what's happening in the current?
Just cutting some bits of cable because I'm going to solder onto these points. One of them's going to be for the tape speed control. One of them will be for the input. One will be for the output. Audio. I've just got to think about how everything's going to end up in this box. Got to think about that. Maybe you can have a little think about the layout. So you want to keep it square like that, do you?
Oh, we could do. We could go, you know, like that, other box.
All that's got to fit in the back is that, and obviously these parts will be showing inside.
Yeah.
There's enough depth. Right, should we do a little bit of soldering?
So we're soldering on all of them now.
Everything that needs to be attached to this, we're going to solder and get it outside of the body so we can rehouse it all.
Yeah.
And then start working on the circuit and the box.
Yes.
Going to take some bits off. This is the switch for the FM and AM thing. Radio. This is the speaker, I think. Yeah. Which we're going to use as our output to this. But I'm going to switch the cable because it feels shit. Sweet. Didn't melt the cable too much. Might. I need to jump on that and not desolder the old one. Got it. And the one for the tape speed. I do believe that is all we need. I'm going to tuck the cables round and find our way. Oh, we're going this way anyway. What am I on about? Okay. We might just have to snip a little bit out of the casing.
Hey.
Just to allow for the cable to come through. Hopefully it don't crack.
Make sure you're wearing eye shields.
A little nick.
Oh, I've gone greedy.
She's all good. Right. We're almost there. Just pop a couple of the screws in. Because this gun will be tested.
The battery.
Couple of them. $5,000. Speed mod, line out, line in. So the line out we need to join into this board, but I want to prep this board first with some cable. There's something else I'm going to do on this board.
Oh yeah,
right. I want to explain this.
R27, you need to take this out you can either do that by cutting with a little Stanley blade or a scalpel, just cutting the contact point there that goes to that leg. You see it?
Yeah.
Or what I do, which seems pretty effective, is just try to grab hold of it and pull it out. Yeah. God. That is so tiny, like.
Yeah.
But it's gone. And that allows you to override the amount of feedback you get and the time.
So now you solder to those points, do you? Or?
Yeah. Well, I'm going to solder to the leg. So that one is what we said it was. Leg 9 is where the overdrive comes in. Yeah. First try.
I fear that Techlord after this is going to replace our name from battery operated into barely operating.
It's been a while, man.
Just look at the way that we build stuff and just be like, oh. Oh, Lord.
Oh, God. Sorry, Techlord. What else? Forgotten what we're doing now.
You miss everything.
I think so. Oh. I need the power thing.
Oh.
Looks complicated.
It's not. Yeah, when you do it bit by bit, it's all good. At the moment, it looks complicated.
So, where are we at? Time to start mounting stuff, I guess.
You want to mount these?
I'm going to mount these.
I mean, drilling in this, yeah.
In or out?
Oh, I was going to say.
I've got a little block of wood somewhere, actually, that I've put the ones in.
Remember, we've only got one project box, right? If we gash this up.
Right, I messed it up already.
Boring! Get it?
Ain't boring technically only underground?
No.
Yeah.
No. Inside a gun barrel was called a bore.
Yeah, they make them underground. We've got two.
Nice.
What's the center of this bad boy?
2.2. 2.2.
Putting it together like this so we can see visually what it's going to look like.
Yeah.
Oh, it's just got to be in the middle of them, hasn't it? Swizz. It's just connecting these two, connecting this to this. That goes in there, the controls for that go in there.
It's going to look cool.
Actually mount luck.
Woo!
We're at the stage now where we're going to be joining this to this and this to these.
Mm-hmm.
And then this to this.
It's gone surprisingly well so far, which...
Don't say that.
It's going to be like our shortest video ever. We actually...
Oh, no!
Yeah, but you never know. These things are can be tricky.
They are, if you boys.
Yeah, they're a bit hit and miss. All right, next bit. I'm going to take this hinge apart to make a connection for that. So I'm thinking, mount that on there. I don't know.
Flatten the hoops with a hammer.
I'll have to peel them open.
Peel them open with a hammer.
Closing it. Mount that bit in a little bit, shall we? Or because we don't want to be moving it about at all after we've stuck this.
Yeah, we'll see that for later. Set.
But it will just get stuck on the back there, and then when we finish mounting all this, that will get stuck on there, and it'll look nice. Oh yeah. I should take this opportunity to coin a new phrase.
Oh, yeah.
Circuit blending.
Oh! Dropping
start
it now.
Start hashtagging it.
Did we not drop it? I swear we dropped that in the last video as well.
No, we didn't.
Did we not? Circuit
check.
Blending.
Circuit blending, isn't it? Take a circuit, take another circuit, blend them up, please.
Oh, yeah. It sounds better than circuit bending. Circuit blending.
Start hashtagging it.
It's our hashtag.
We want a wiki page by next week.
TM. TM on all of that. Yeah, see, yeah, but I think, like, the thing is, it looks complicated.
It's not complicated.
But step by step, you know, just going, like, bit by bit, that's all that's happening. Obviously... We're not saying you can just go and do this tomorrow.
You can.
But we're saying try.
Have a go.
Yeah. Because you'll be surprised, because, like, we ain't good.
I ain't good.
And this is just giving it a go. This one's worked out really well because it's a combination of everything that we've been doing for the past few years, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of the tape loop.
It's messing with these, which we've messed with quite a lot. And doing the pots and soldering is something we've been honing.
There's that many project boxes. There's only like...
Mounting stuff is like our thing that we're not good at.
There's loads of things we're not good at.
We always struggle.
I still think this has been my finest work when it comes to mounting stuff properly.
Yeah. And even that's a little wonky.
Yeah, I tried so hard, man.
But yeah, we're electronics guys. We're just, you know, don't get involved with carpentry or plastic.
We're artists.
Yeah, that's what we are.
That's what we. This is my
that one.
Because you can just get away with anything.
Yeah, if it don't work, weren't supposed to, mate.
It's art. Right, soldering montage. There's no line in on these things, there's only a mic in.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh dear.
But now there's a line in.
Mm-hmm.
I have a line out. I'm through the process part of it.
Yeah.
I think if we sort this power out, we can test it. Thank you.
hear sound.
It's a good sign.
Yes.
First time it ever worked, first time.
If we want, we can make this all tidy, like really nice.
Yeah.
And make it short. Mm-hmm. We can do that. Or we can just tuck it all in under this piece of foam. Get this out.
There's the lid.
Nothing wrong with that, mate.
Is it? It's going to be like a jack in a box.
No, it's all right. It's just sitting there.
That's it. There's the screws.
So we're at the stage where we're trying to stick it together now.
Hinge time.
Go for both at the same time or one and the other?
I think we're better to do one and the other.
This is worse than the solder. Just high now.
Squidge out of the top. You can seal it in.
Oh, just got a thought. Pretty much just sealed it shut forever. Because it overlaps this joint.
Well.
Yeah, never getting in there, Tech Lord.
Stick that to there then. Stop it rocking as well.
Yeah.
I don't want to overdo it on this one.
I think, yeah, paint that.
It's just wherever it connects with it, isn't it? Square.
Yeah, man. It looks nice, it's all black and stuff.
The bracket's fucking hidden, like, it's pretty nice.
Yeah.
Just hope we can get into that battery compartment.
side of the chassis.
I think Techmoan could come back at us and say, you're saying the unit's good, but you've attached two very large things to it to make it any good. So life support.
Yeah.
But
look, it looks so cool. Look at it.
Yeah, I think it's a good little project unit.
I wouldn't want
that,
that crow
getting his word in.
Getting big. Our videos, that crow. I like it.
Yeah.
But it has its problems. It's still a bush portable tape player. Yeah. But if we're after weird and wonderful sounds, then I think this is fine.
Yeah, we're lo-fi.
That's what it is. It's lo-fi. It'd be interesting to see what we can do with it as with the radio, if we can send that straight to tape and do like lucky dip loops, see what we can record like straight off a radio station. It's an all-in-one little ambient machine, isn't it? If you put a loop in there and mess around with the echo and stuff,
yeah,
it just generates some sound, like some atmosphere.
Yeah,
pretty quickly. Should we play some tape for that?
We'll have to do some demos.
Yes.
This is all the connections you've got other than a power on the other side.
Yeah.
So there's an onboard mic. We added the wire from there to there. So you've got a line in.
And you can also record the radio as well. But
should we give that a go first?
Yeah.
Or is that just going to make people want to switch off? Because
the copyrighted music is all I'm concerned about. But if we're on classical, it's fine.
That's just the quality.
That's the internal function of this machine.
Make it robotic.
So quiet.
Like a vapor engine.
Vapor engine. Yeah, so it'd be fucking sweet, man, if that fucking noise wasn't in there so bad.
Oh, God.
This tape.
Yeah, because you could make, like, you could do like lucky dip samples, so it'd be well good fun.
Yeah. Like, that'd be sweet to just grab that. Like, the cool thing is, you can play the radio, not record it to tape, and affect.
Oh yeah.
The thing.
The famous forces need to get the ball rolling. It's interesting that you can identify one or more, of course, of one of the following famous forces that you can attach. 0808, 109,
100. That's funny. Remix the radio.
That would just stay there, I think.
Have you got one of those? I'll sing to Rainy, she loves it.
Oh, that's lovely. And what does she request?
You know, we're not trying to say that Techmoan was wrong.
Obviously, it's a piece of
like,
shit.
It is a piece of crap.
Never, don't buy it.
But there's redeemable functionality here.
We're going to prove that it ain't useless. That's the point.
Yeah, yeah. There are a few functions if you're a fucking tinkerer dweeb.
But, yeah.
So it's not completely useless.
It's pretty bad.
But it would have to be three times better than that to be considered complete crap.
Quite in tech lord.
We did the best of a bad job.
Yeah.
Put loops in it, mess with the radio, put fucking ready recorded tapes in it. That's it.
Bush.
You suck.
Techlord, we will send this to you.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to join your Patreon to get you... Yeah. This sounds... Wait, hold on. I just realised. That's the... We're going to join...
We're going to join... We're going to join the cult of Techlord.
We're going... No, we couldn't find any contact details for the guy. So we're going to join his Patreon and drop him a message and see if he's interested in...
Ship this little bad boy to him.
See if he enjoys it as much as we didn't. I mean,
it was like our quickest build. It worked. Like,
it looks well
up.
Good.
I think it looks fun, yeah.
I think, to be honest, quite a lot of our builds
look good, sound bad.
I don't think we should give up trying to record into it. I should go get like an OP1 that we've got a little bit more volume control over and just try and record something into it that isn't absolute trash.
Yeah. We can give that a go.
Just for my own sanity, like.
Yeah.
It's upsetting me.
Let's do it, just as the outro. I mean,
pocket operators are hot as fuck.
They are uncontrollably hot.
It's gonna be hot as hell.
I think it sounds nice though. Try and contact Techmoan and send this to him. See if he has any fun with it. We'll do that just for the meme. Don't expect him to do anything with it. just to be like,
gonna look confused. See? He'll just look well confused when it turns up.
That's worth it to me.
Yeah.
Anyway,
well,
we're out. We're gonna do more stuff. We got stuff coming up. What we got?
We got this thing coming up. Oh.
Spoiler.
Has it been on our Instagram yet?
Yeah. We've got stuff coming up.
We've got stuff coming
up. Keep an eye on the page. Follow us on Insta. Subscribe. If you watch us regularly and you're not subscribed, subscribe, because it fucking...
It'd be good if we post regularly. It helps. People could watch us. We've got plenty of builds coming anyway.
New shit on the way. New shit. Stuff. Workshop's getting more and more packed.
Yeah, don't film the whole workshop. It's a fucking mess.
Right. Yes. Boom. See ya.
Peace. Let's find one that's good.